So the airframe team are frantically implementing all of the design changes that have been made over the last 18 months or so into the latest fuselage design so that we can release the tools for the prototype airframe production. And one of the areas that's been a long-standing balancing act for us is the internal packaging of the nose area of HX50. As you're aware, in order to get the longitudinal range of CG that we need to give you essentially carefree handling at any end of the gross weight spectrum, we use a small trim tank located in the nose in the forward part of the instrument panel. But of course, in that area, we've also got to consider the packaging of the high performance nose light, the packaging of the retractable nose undercarriage, and the routing of the cyclic and collective flight control runs and flight control cables on the inside of the nose beam. We've essentially spent the last week or two finalizing that package there and making the final divvy up of the space needed to be able to implement that in the tools. That's gone really well. In addition to that, we've also now laid down the final routings for the fuel transfer tubes to transfer the fuel from the main tank to the trim tank in both directions to transparently manage the transmission of that fuel both ways. So it's simple, easy, and completely transparent to the pilot, not something you have to worry about. There's a lot of engineering detail goes into getting a structure as sophisticated as this ready for volume production. And over the course of the last 2 weeks, what the composites team have been focusing on is how we take this structural concept and make it fit for purpose for volume manufacture. So we're maintaining the monolage, this idea of an integral outer shell without any joints in it. But all of these internal details, the longitudinal beams, the cross beams, the floor panels, the bulkheads that define the back of the cabin, and then the fuel bay and the baggage bay floor, how we bring those together as pre-cured composite elements and under a much simpler assembly process has received an awful lot of attention recently. And what this does for us is it completely eliminates the need for our composite laminators to be crawling around inside this volume, trying to laminate around foam cores. It makes the structure much easier to produce reliably, faster to produce reliably, and much easier to scale up to production, so we can hit the production volumes that we need for this thing. Another important feature that we're building into the latest generation of tools is the way that we attach the front windows in particular. While it's quite reasonable and quite safe to bond the side windows for the door onto the fuselage, these front windows are subject to extremely high loads during bird strike. And one of the details that we've developed over the course of the last couple of weeks is essentially making this body colored trim part essentially removable so that we can create a joggle feature to hide some mechanical fasteners along the ridge line of the nose, and we can do something similar as we wrap around the door opening so that the window is secured mechanically as well as with a bonded joint around the longest parts of its periphery. And this is crucial to delivering the really high levels of bird strike integrity that we need for HX50 and the latest generation of the certification requirements. In addition to that, you'll notice on these very early windows, there was some wrinkling on the nose line. And the reason for that is we'd originally intended to form these windows using a vacuum forming process and ended up producing the first prototype ones with drape forming, but the tools weren't appropriate for drape forming. So the tools I just showed you down at the other end of the factory that we're producing at the moment are the extended drape forming tools that we'll use to produce the second generation of glazing for the front of the prototype HX50 nose. So all of that's coming together very nicely. Other features that are being baked in, we're going to talk about lights from an optical point of view shortly, but the latest generation of lights are a slightly different shape to the very first ones in terms of their interface with the fuselage. So we've captured that in the latest version for both the nose, the signature light down the side, and also the wingtip lights. Another area that we've been developing is the process of how we paint these things effectively in production. Let's talk about that next. lightweight, high-performance composite panels are actually quite difficult to paint well. And the reason for that is these very thin laminates that have very strongly woven fabrics, lightning protection, and thin layers of honeycomb core in the center of them create all kinds of witness marks on the surface that you then have to try and build up and smooth out with layers and layers of high build primer. That process doesn't work from a production point of view, and it doesn't work from a weight point of view for an aircraft. So one of the techniques that we've been experimenting with over the course of the last couple of weeks to elevate the fuselage from prototype status to production ready is the use of a film-based primer. So what this is it's a product where we have a epoxy-based primer that's laid on in the form of a film onto an ultra-thin layer of chop strand glass. And what that does, that scrim layer, allows us to essentially disguise and fill out the lightning strike protection and also any witness marks from the honeycomb coming through the carbon, and gives us a beautiful paintable surface straight out of the mold. So all we need to do when the component comes out of the mold is have a light sand across the body, and then you're directly ready to go to color coat and top coat. So it's a really efficient production process, and we've been doing some test samples of that over the last couple of weeks or so, and it's looking really good. In addition to that, we've also been training our in-house staff in the painting processes that we want to use. So a couple of the lads have been on a painting course specifically focused on the paint systems that we're going to use with the aircraft, and also the nature of our materials, to develop the in-house expertise to get truly world-class finishes on each and every one of these aircraft. So the key with this stage of the program now is we do have to capture every single solitary last detail that we want to be there in the production aircraft. And one of the other areas that the airframe team are working on is everything to do with the door closures and getting those to production grade. The touch, the feel, the interaction, all of it, particularly with attention to the seals, so that we don't have drafts, so that we don't let water in. So we've got the proper rain gutter features in there so that the rainwater will flow not directly into the cabin and be channeled away. And so that we keep all of the doors closed and snug and aerodynamically fared along these beautiful lines of the body. The next generation of the fuselage also captures all of the work that we've been doing on the ergonomics in particular. So all of these beam sections have now been able to be reduced on account of the improved structural design of the aircraft. So smaller roof beams, smaller nose beams, smaller side pillars. We've expanded the A-pillar junction out a little bit, and we now can accommodate everything from a first centile woman through to a 99th centile man in comfort. We'll talk about the crashworthy seat shortly, but from an ergonomics perspective, HX50 is genuinely class leading. Now I'm really excited to report that we'll shortly be prototyping the very first crashworthy hill cabin crew seat that's going to be subjected to the full certification crash tests. Now this is a seat that takes all of the learnings from the ergonomic work that we've done, all of the customer feedback in terms of comfort, cushion softness, base angle, back angle, lumbar support, brings all of that together into a single product that will both meet all of the comfort requirements but also all of the structural and crashworthy requirements. In addition to that, we've implemented all of the connection features into the new generation of the fuselage, so that the co-pilot seat and all three of the rear seats are removable by the pilot. The rear seats themselves fit to the bulkhead, so you've got a completely open floor space and a flat cabin floor to give the utility version, or the commercial version of the aircraft, the greatest possible flexibility. So these new seats will essentially be everything that you know and love about the Hill crew seat, but these ones will be crashworthy and compliant with the very latest versions of both the European and the US certification standards.